Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to slow down a part of your video using DaVinci Resolve 17. A lot of us like to take fast action videos and if you're like me, I like to slow down just a section of it so people can see what they've missed. This is your case, you're going to be wanting to see this video. My name is Alex, and if this is your first time visiting my channel, feel free to observe any video that you like. And if you like what you see, including this video, give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so to begin, I'm going to choose the video that I recorded, and that's of an alligator. I do wildlife photography and videography. If you have never seen my wildlife channel, I encourage you to check that out by clicking the link above. I think 95% of all my videos has to do with alligators, and so it's pretty cool. So please check it out. If you like it, hit the thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel because I'm always uploading new videos all the time. So my recent video is this alligator. It's a female alligator, all in the wild, by the way. There's no zoo captivities here. This female alligator in the wild, she's trying to fish for turtles, fish, whatever it is that she's trying to fish for. And a garfish literally jumps over her back. Now, I did not know I recorded this until actually I came home and played it back. Thought that was pretty awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and now keep the regular segment, and then I'm going to slow it down so that others can enjoy what they missed. So how you do this? Well, once you place your video on your timeline, very important that you make sure that the timeline frame rate matches the frame rate that you record it in. I highly recommend that if you want to slow down any portion of the video, always record at 60 frames per second, because that's the ideal frame rate that you want to use on your camera setting to slow down footages. So in order for you to make sure that everything's matched up okay, you can go ahead and click on this little pinwheel here. It's a setting wheel. And then make sure that you have everything set correctly. Now, I already had my timeline preset, but I'll show you what I did. In my timeline resolution, I chose 1280 by 720 HD at 720p, okay? And then coming down, I wanna make sure that normally this would be highlighted and you'll see it clear, but since it's already been chosen and it's darkened out, I chose 59.94 frames per second because that's what my setting is on my camera. And when you play back frame rate, it automatically will match the same thing. So you don't have to change anything, but just in case it's different, you want to make sure it's the same as your timeline frame rate. Now in the video format, I chose HD 720p at 59.94. And that's basically it. That's all you have to do. So usually this would be highlighted. You just click save. In this case, I'm going to hit cancel because I already preset my timeline. So now that I'm back at my timeline, what I'm going to do now is find my location where I want to start, where I want to slow down, and where I want to leave off, okay? So there's three things you need to do. First, let's find our location. And in this case, it's going to be where the gator is fishing. And here she is. Boom. There's the fish, okay? You can see the fish jumping right over her. Check that out. That's pretty cool, ain't it? All right, so I'm gonna start right there just before the fish makes the jump. I'm gonna go ahead and click on my razor blade. I'm going to snip it by clicking on the video, and automatically it's gonna also click the audio because it's linked together. I'll choose my arrow. And I'm going to highlight the segment I'm going to delete because I'm not going to need that. All right. So I'm going to start basically where the fish just jumps, leaps over the water. Right over the water. Okay. Now, once I see the fish jumping over the water, just when the tail hits, I'm going to go a little further. There's the tail, piece of tail sticking out to your right, back into the water. I'm going to continue until I get right there. I'm gonna stop it right here. I'm gonna go ahead and take the razor blade. I'm gonna go ahead and clip that, okay? And then I'm gonna take my cursor and I'm just going to measure where I'm gonna stop a little bit later. Okay, I know where I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna take my cursor now by hitting the arrow right here. Click on cursor, click on the rest of the video, just delete it. You're gonna get rid of it, okay? What you're gonna do is keep the original video clip that you want to slow down. So keep this original, right? Now what you're gonna do is take your cursor, left click, right click, choose copy, and hit paste. That's the video you're gonna slow down, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and keep that right there. Now I'm gonna go ahead, and since it's already been selected, I'm gonna go ahead and right click, and I'm gonna go where it says change clip speed. Click on that, you're gonna see that automatically my frame rate is showing at 59.94, that's where I want it. But you're gonna notice speed rate here is at 100. That's the normal speed, that's the default speed. So what I'm gonna do is slow it down. Now technically I could go 40%, but I wanna go lower. I'm gonna take it and go 25%. Click on that, so now this is 25%. So when you play it, it's not gonna show you the fist, just barely jumping out. So what you're gonna have to do is stretch it, and you're gonna see the fish. And you're going to stop it where the second splash comes in from the tail. Boom, stop it right there. Okay. And then I'm going to delete what I don't need. So I'm going to use this, I'm going to scroll until I see the fish head, which is right there. So it's not much. I'm going to stop it right there. Take your razor blade, clip it, cursor, click on that so you can select it, hit delete. And now what happens? Let's replay. You have the regular speed, and now you have the slow motion speed. Boom. All right, very cool. Now keep in mind too, anytime you slow down your video as a slow motion, your audio is going to do the same thing. It doesn't sound too appealing when you replay it. Now the first frame is going to sound good because it's your normal frame. The audio is going to sound just as great. But when you slow down the video, the one that you want to slow down to show your family and friends, the audio is going to be unpleasant because that's going to slow down too. So how do we fix that? Well, first thing you want to do is you're going to go back to the second frame here that you slow down. You're going to select that. And what you're going to do is unlink the audio from the video. How do you do this? Well, once you select it, just right click, and you're going to see where it says link clips. So just click that. So once you do that, you unlinked it. So you can choose, you can select anywhere in the gray or on other video where you want to do. So you can get out of the whole selection part of it, and then just select the audio. See where it highlighted? You can select the video or you can select the audio. In this case, we're going to select the audio because we want to delete it. So delete your audio. Oops. Let me show you something. This is very important, and I forgot to bring this out. Anytime you delete something from your timeline, there's a certain way you should delete it. Here's the mistake I just made. It just popped up. So I'm going to delete the audio, right? If you hit the delete button on your keypad, notice what happens. It just basically pushed everything out, and look where you're at. It deleted the first frame. You don't want to do that. So hit Control Z. Sometimes you forget. So the best way to delete something from your timeline, select it, right click, and go up to where it says delete selected. Once you click on that, there you have deleted your audio, and everything stays in its same spot. That's so important. When I first used DaVinci Resolve and I started doing this, I'm like, whoa, where's my frame? What happened here? What happened there? All right, so enough of that. So now what you're gonna do is replace the slowdown audio that you just deleted. And now you're gonna take the real audio and you're gonna match it up with the slow motion audio so it can sound realistic. So all you're gonna do is borrow from this guy right here, your first frame, right? Your normal frame. It's going to be, when you select it, it's going to be linked together. So you have to unlink that, remember? Just select it. You're going to right click and hit link clips. Click anywhere in the gray. And now you basically unlinked it. All you're gonna do is make a copy of the audio, leave the audio in its place. All you're gonna do is make a copy, make a right click there, choose copy, bring your cursor out so that way when you paste it, you don't run into anything. All right, so there you have it. There you have the original sound of the fish splashing. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to take my cursor and listen to where the splash begins. Okay, know where it's at. So this little portion right here is where the splash begins. Even though you see a big spike right here, that's not where the splash is. It starts right here. So now what I'm gonna do is take the cursor and follow along the video of where that splash begins. And that splash is gonna begin not when the fish goes into the water, but when the fish smacks the water, right there. Smacks the water. So I'm gonna leave my cursor here, and so that I don't forget where this splash is, I'm gonna take this marker, I'm gonna click on it, and I'm gonna mark it in blue right there. You could actually name the marker if you want to, not necessary for this portion of the video. And all I'm gonna do is match this little spike to where the marker is. And that way, it can match the timeline. Now, if you find that your audio goes a little too far and you can't set it right, take your Alt key on your keypad and your wheel mouse and just make it bigger. Just scroll and make it bigger. And then you can see where yes, see that? See, I'm kind of off. So the marker is right there, but the sound is right there. So I'm going to move it right there. Okay, so I'm going to match it up. There we go. All right. Now take my Alt key, go back to normal. Then what I'll do is I'll stretch the remaining audio to match the video. Okay. So what you're going to do now is start over, see what happens. Perfect. That is perfect. Okay. So now what I'm going to do, because I don't want the video to stop there, and the reason being is because I want the video to go back to normal. So that way you'll have the normal view, slow motion view, back to normal view, make it really smooth. So what I did was I basically moved the cursor to the end. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to link the audio and the video together by taking my left mouse, clicking on the video, holding down your control button, and then you're going to click on the audio. You're going to right click, and then you're going to go ahead and click link clips. Just click it. Now you just linked it together. So if you grab the video, you're going to see that the audio is also grabbed. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to stretch out the remaining video, which by the way is still in slow motion. And I'm going to basically go until I see that the gator is going to make a splash right there and then stop. See? So make a splash and then stop right there. Okay. Then I'm going to take my razor blade and I'm going to cut the video here. And then what I'm going to do from that point, I'm going to take the cursor, click on the arrow button here, and select just the audio and video that I just cut. Remember, it's still in slow motion and I don't want that in slow motion. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to go back to where it says change clip speed. And it's still set on 25 because it's on slow motion. I'm just going to double click on that and choose 100. That's going to bring it back to normal. So now what we're going to do is we're going to play back. Hit play. Normal speed. Slow motion speed. And back to normal. There you go. So it went from normal, slow motion, normal. So people can see that, wow, that was pretty cool, and then went back in slow motion. Basically, that's how you do it. It's really simple, it's really easy, it takes practice. Whether you like to do fast action videos, bicycles, skateboards, whatever it is that you're doing, That's exactly how you do it with DaVinci Resolve 17. If you're using DaVinci Resolve 16, basically it's the same thing. You're not going to miss anything out. So if you're using 16, don't be discouraged. Continue to watch this video because it's going to work for that too. Thank you guys for watching my video. Until my next video, see ya.